Hi, Robin Phillips here from Rep Music again, and just sharing with you another load of testing that we've been doing. This one has sort of come together over time. Today we're looking at 67 mics, obviously all based on the Neumann U67. And the big question now, this is a real VIP go-to dream mic cabinet mic for a lot of people. And I was trying to decide, you know, with my cabinet, do I need or want a 67. Now there's a load of mods out there as well, mods and clones. So I was doing some testing. I was lucky enough to borrow a U67 reissue to test out. And while I had it, I used it as an opportunity to test out some other ways of doing things. And I'd heard about the Max Kircher 67, which is this. U67 actually first came out in 1960. It was Neumann's replacement for the U47. Now, we're still talking tubes, but the big introduction here is the K67 capsule. And this has been used almost ever since, you know. It's still used now, hence the fact we can do what we did. So, Max Kircher makes a mod for the U87, the AI, the new one, and also it's the same mod that works with the TLM67. Now, if I just bring this out here, I can show you. We've got a bit of a Frankenstein mic here going on. This is the inside of the TLM67. And you can see there's not a lot going on in there, actually. But what it does have is it has the K67 capsule, and it has a case that has the anniversary. I think they just wanted to make the TLM look different to the U, because of course there's a big price differentiation as well. But what you can do is by buying the TLM67 or the U87ai is you get the K67 capsule. And Max Kircher in Austria makes this this mod that you can literally just drop in, a bit like I was just showing you then. It just drops straight in, and what you're then getting is a tube and a circuitry based on the blueprints of the U67. And look, people will get all detailed about this, and this is a bit of a deep dive, we're going a bit geeky. But you can change out the tube, or you can go with the one that Max recommends. And in fact, that's what I did. I went and got a NOS. This is the Telefunken 1969 replacement tube, and I put it in. And we'll hear it in a minute. What does the tube do to it? Because part of me was thinking you just replace all the elements to try and get a NOS, new old stock, of course, going back to the original stuff. Some people will even say you need to replace these BV12s to get the original one to get that sound. Actually, I think Max really knows what he's doing. And when I chatted to him about it, he said there's no benefit to that at all. And when I normally do a test, as you've seen on my other videos, check them out, don't forget. Check them out. I like to do a single take with mics with capsules as close as possible, because those little nuances in a different take can actually be as much as the difference between a mic. But with this, you can't if you're changing bodies out and tubes out. So these they weren't even all done on the same day, but you get great info, I think. Once we've level matched, how much difference is there? Now, I've managed to record with the TLM67, the MK67 and the U67ai, the reissue. Of course, I couldn't get a vintage. We're talking £11,000-£12,000 for that. And the reissues are going for about £5,000, I think, at the moment, four something, maybe five. That's a lot of money. Now, what did the U67 do? Well, and what does it give you? Because we've got the U87 over here. This is a super cutting mic. It's been used, as we know, since the 80s, loads of pop tracks on this. The U67 offers still a bit of tube, but with the K67 capsule. And you do sort of get that, I think you do get that hybrid between the 87 and the 47. The 47, maybe almost like a slower response, and it's super warm. This one has a bit of both. Now, since I did this test, I've kept my Max Kircher 67. I've actually not gone with the NOS tube, because you can hear, it's a warm mic anyway. And the tube, if you go to a NOS one, now then as soon as you get a new old stock tubes, they're all different as well. So how do you know you'll get, even if it's new old stock, they all sound different. You'd have to buy five and swap them all out. And I don't think, you know, I didn't have time for that. So I've kept the Max Kircher tube, and I can't remember which one he's put in there. We'll add that to the description. And, but Max did this amazing thing as well. He's changed the circuitry to be more like the reissue. And by putting on the low cut, the high pass switch, that actually engages the reissue circuitry. And that takes away a little bit of that low end, you know, we could say warmth. Does it get muffled if it's like the original? I wasn't there when the original came out. So for me, reissue setting, Max Kircher drop in on this TLM67 with the K67 capsule is an incredible mic. And what are you talking about? 1500 quid, something like that for the TLM, $2,000 or something for Max's drop in. You're dropping a few thousand pounds, but you're not getting near the reissue. Is it that much different to get the reissue? Well, we're going to have a listen and you can let me know what you think. Do stay in touch. Don't forget to subscribe, like, please do comment, ask me questions. I'm happy to continue this chat. But since I did this, I put it up in some mic shootouts, saxophone, guitar as well. The 67 nearly always wins. It's a great mic. Look, let's get into the actual audio. Thanks for listening, and you'll be out of here. We go through different things from just the Focusrite Red 8 Pre. We use also the air setting on Focusrite to give a little bit of that lift. As I said, sometimes it can all get a bit too warm. You hit tube into tube preamp. And then we've alternate with a few different preamps. We've got the UA4710, my DAV as well, and the API. And then we swap out the tube. And I've also got it with the TLM67 as well. And tell you what, the TLM67 sounds pretty amazing. So there's loads of different versions of this. You can see, do you really need all those different, do you really need all these things? Or could you just buy a TLM and just be really happy with a bit of EQ? Okay, here we go. Cans on, listening in, starting off with the U67 and then running through them. I'll try not to comment when you're listening. I'll say something if it jumps out.
Turn down the lights, turn down the bed, turn down these voices.
It's the reissue of the 67.
Lay down with me, tell me no lies, just hold me close, don't patronize.
I can't believe how similar that is.
Don't patronize.
That's the MK67 reissue setting API.
Cause I can't make you love me if you don't.
This is the TLM standard.
You can't make your heart feel something that it won't tear in the dark.
That's for the UA.
In these final hours, I will lay down my heart and I feel the power that you won't. No, you won't.
Switching back to the MK67.
Cause I can't make you love me.
Just through the Red 8 Pre.
If you don't.
I'm going to go to the MK67 through the UA 4710 Mic Tube Pre.
I close my eyes, then I won't see the love you don't feel when you're holding me. Morning will come, and I'll do what's right.
Softens all the edges.
Just give me till then to give up this fight.
It's a bit at the top.
And I will give up this fight.
Same Morse tube through the UA.
Cause I can't make you love me if you don't. You can't make your heart feel something that it won't tear in the dark. In these final hours, I will lay down my heart. I feel the power that you won't.
Air on the Red 8 Pre helps this.
No, you won't.
I've got the Neumann tube in.
Cause I can't make you love me if you don't.
Wow, some very subtle differences there. Just going to say on that. You know, there's a lot of the M, because I was trying to work out how to set this up. So there's obviously a lot of the MK67 rather than going between the TLM and between the U67. But the subtle differences, I would just say, and this is something I've learned, you know, tube mic into tube preamp, sometimes you're just getting a lot of tube warmth. Softens the edges, you lose a bit of the top, but you can lose a bit of that punch and a bit of that clarity. The Red 8 Pre does a great job. And the Red 8 Pre with the air setting really helped on the tube. And then, but the TLM67 as stock standard is a great sounding mic. It's amazing now that we've level matched these, the differences are so subtle. And we're gonna have another list run through now, and we're gonna listen to them with the, so that was just the MK67 standard. Now we're gonna switch on that reissue setting and see what the reissue setting sounds like with some different variations. Gonna run through some different pre's and also with that air setting on the Focusrite. Here we go. Don't forget, please do like, comment, subscribe, and we'll keep the conversation going online. Okay, so continuing now, we'll get a bit of a deeper dive into that MK67, but with the reissue setting on. We're going to run through the red and the API, which is the A2D, by the way, that has the 312 preamp, but the digital converter in it. We've got the UA4710, the DAV, got to check out DAV preamps, they're amazing. Made in London, and then we whack the tube in again reissue setting. So let's have a little listen, starting with the 67 MK67 reissue through the red.
Turn down the light, turn down the bed, turn down these voices inside my head.
That's nice.
Lay down with me, tell me no lies.
Switch into the API.
Just hold me close, don't patronize, don't patronize me.
Now to the UA.
'Cause I can't make you love me if you don't.
Warmer.
You can make your heart feel something that it won't, hair in the dark.
Now to the DAV.
These final hours, I will lay down my heart, and I feel the power that you won't.
That sounds great.
Won't. 'Cause I can't make you love me if you don't.
Yeah, the last bit was with that EF86 tube dropped in. It really warms it up, doesn't it? But the reissue setting brightens it a little bit.
I close my eyes, then I won't see.
Got the air.
Love you don't feel, and you're holding me.
I know all those again.
Morning will come, and I'll do what's right.
Yeah, definitely adds something.
Give me till then to give up this fight, and I will give up this fight.
That's the API. It's a bit cleaner.
I can't make you love me if you don't.
I think I was a bit further off the mic on this take.
You can't make your heart feel something that it won't, here in the dark.
So the tube preamp with the UA?
Hours, I will lay down my heart, and I feel the power that you won't.
The DAV.
No, you won't. 'Cause I can't make you love me if you don't.
Finishing with the NOS tube, reissue setting, and the Red 8 Pre. Okay, yeah, you know, the reissue setting lifts the mic a little bit on this MK67. It is my preferred setting, but the air setting on the Focusrite actually really does add a little bit of that top to it. Again, when you put tube in tube, you get that added up tubeness and the warmth. The API, I said a couple of times here, it's a bit cleaner. It is a bit sort of cleaner, but also I can see here, I think I was slightly further off the mic on that take, and of course that will have an impact on the proximity effect as well. Those differences are tiny. Where did I end up? I love the Max Kircher 67, I think it's brilliant. I'm not doing this for him, but there was nothing out there, so I thought, I've done this test, share the video, because hopefully it will help somebody make that decision. I didn't feel the need actually to keep the NOS tube in there. I do think the reissue into either the DAV or the API pre really help. I don't tend to go tube mic, tube pre. I hope you got some information from this. Thanks for checking out all these videos. And let us know what you think. Comment, like, subscribe. I'll see you soon. This is Robin from Rep Music. Check it out.